is so stupid, it's positively brilliant.
Listen, let's talk about the Kev shit for a minute, though. Yeah, I'm going to tell you why I thought that was fucked up. Yeah. Two reasons.
Kev mad drunk.
We all was drunk. But first of all, Lil Nas X should have never been put in that situation. Mm-hmm. Right? And I'm going to tell you why he should have never been put in that situation. He should have never been put in that situation because what Kev said is absolutely true. We don't care.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, if you want to have a moment with Lil Nas X talking about his sexuality, make that a real moment. Like, if we were all in a barbershop for real and we was all drinking, I wouldn't be asking them about his goddamn sexuality.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Nobody else in there got asked about their sexuality. You know what I'm saying? Nobody in there got... Kev didn't get asked about his infidelity or anything. So, like, why bring that up?
But I don't think people got mad at him getting asked about it. I think people got mad because he was so dismissive. And it was like, oh, that's his homophobia speaking
no,
out.
No, that was a little out of context. And the reason it was a little out of context because what we was trying to tell Lil Nas X is, bro, it's cool. Like, you don't have to talk about that here if you don't want to. The kid is 20 years old. Do you really think he's comfortable with his sexuality? And they have to live that out in the public eye? Like, you say something like that, and then immediately social media is all over you, calling you gay and the F word, I mean, and all kind of other
stuff.
He's kind of
took it in stride. He was the one making most of the jokes himself when he first came out.
Yeah, but how do we know? Yeah. How do we know he's not at home crying?
We don't.
You understand what I'm saying? Like, we don't know. So it's just like, why put him in the hot seat? And by the way, let's not act like that was a regular conversation. That was for TV. That was a producer question. Like, make sure you ask Lil Nas this so we can get these moments. You know that, though. Anybody that does content, that does media, you know that. So why? Mm. Why? What was the meaning of that? That conversation went nowhere. All it did this morning was cause a bunch of uproar for what? You had so many other great discussions going on.
Yo, you can't even really talk about these issues. That's the tricky thing. It's like,
and that's,
second you bring up trans, second you bring up anything homosexual, like, and even the discussion itself becomes some hot button topic. Like, it's actually exhausting.
Yeah.
I get exhausted by the fact that you can't even ask a fucking question.
Listen, if we was being honest, we should have had, and I mean, I'm not a producer on the show, so I don't know, but I would have had Paul ask Kev about his homophobic tweets from back in the day.
Boom.
What did he learn from it?
Yes.
Lil Nas X, how did you feel when you saw that? And then you can have a good conversation.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like that. Like, why just put him on the spot about
but
his
see,
sexuality?
But see, I even think that would get him even more fucked up.
I think so too.
I think it would have got him more fucked up because the thing with Kev is, for him, it doesn't matter what he says. Because anybody, especially with the Dave Chappelle shit, with the dollhouse and all that type of stuff, right after that, no matter what he said, people are going to find some shit to get on Kev about.
And that's what they did with this episode last night. All he simply said was, he came out and said he was gay, who cares? Yeah. Which is it's a new drop for the Breakfast Club. That's our new pause, by the way. Whenever somebody says anything remotely gay,
you go, who cares?
We playing the Kevin Hart drop.
Oh, I love it.
You know what I'm saying? It's a great drop. Yeah. You know what I mean? But that is the truth to the matter.
I like how Lil Nas gave a pushback, though. He was like, because Kev tried to act like there's no homophobia.
Boom. Now, that would have been a great conversation.
Yeah. I like that because he was like, bro, if you... I like how he kind of checks that, Kevin.
Yo, but he goes, said he's right. I know. I was like, yo,
he said he was right.
But like, he was like,
but they
you
cut you out
of
all the
hood,
clips is the problem. That's the thing.
Shut up. But I was like, yo, you right. Like, we can't act like pause and no homophobia. Homo didn't exist.
I wish that made it to air, Charlamagne. That was an important conversation. They should have given you more respect over there.
They did.
Dude, nah, that was fucked up.
Right, like off camera, like a producer. You had producer respect.
That was great. And even the seat you were in had your name on the back, like the director's chair. I don't even think you were supposed to be in the shot. did you notice?
I'll tell you, I was proud of my performance.
I wish I could be. I
love this emotionally stable Charlamagne, bro.
I was good.
I hate this, bro. We just make fun of you, and you're like, you know what?
I did well. Listen, I did well. Investing in
HBO
your mental
HBO made
world.
A meme of me. They made a meme of me in one of my quotes from the show.
Wait, what did it say? Have you seen this man?
Well, listen. Since you guys asked. Hold on.
That's not meme. That's missing.
Well, hold on. Since you guys asked.
Oh, fuck.
I don't remember what the fuck it was.
I'm saying like, you're not going to find that.
But I did feel like they taking Kev out of context based off his... And I'm going to tell you what else
I had. You got an Amber Alert, Charlamagne.
I was there. It was great.
It was Kaz really set you up, bro.
Listen, Kaz set you all up disrespectful. All I was trying to say when this conversation started was that when I see those conversations happen, I don't look at being like, oh, Kevin Hart's homophobic. I just look at, oh, this is somebody who just hasn't been educated enough.
Kevin Hart's
why don't some people just fucking educate
him? Educated on what, though?
Just like why the way he, why people...
All right,
people getting mad at him with the homophobic comments, back to whatever.
There's a height requirement for homophobia. I think, I really do believe in this. I agree.
Kevin Hart's racism too.
It's like when a kid says something bad. It's like it's not affecting really anybody.
And sexism.
Is like any gay guy afraid of Kevin Hart? All these gay guys will beat the fucking shit out of Kevin Hart.
Yo.
Come on. Oh, that's probably why Kevin Hart jogging all the time. Get the fuck away. Like he can't run out of breath. Yo, real talk.
I just think that we're so quick to label people things that they aren't. Like I'm reading. I just finished reading Malcolm Gladwell's new book. It's called Talking to Strangers. It comes out, I think, September 10th. And it's about communication and how nobody has it anymore in 2019, 2020. We don't know how to communicate with each other anymore. So I think the subtitle is like the things you should know about the people you don't know. And we try to judge people based off demeanor. Like that's the problem with police officers and everything. Like you might be sitting there, gray hoodie, thick thighs, you know, looking at me like that. And I'm like, damn, who is this motherfucker that looks like he beat up Jussie Smollett? But on the inside, he's hurting.
Yeah.
Because of a tragic situation. I'm just saying, like, we look at somebody's demeanor and we think that we can judge a person. That's wrong. And I think that we do that with Kev. Just because Kev said, so why do you think he's gay? How does that translate to homophobia?
I think Kev was trying to cover for the whatever he's been labeled as homophobic in the past and try to be like, I don't care.
Yeah,
I think his mind, he was trying to say, calculate,
100%.
How do I prove to everybody that I don't care if somebody's gay? Yeah. I'm going to just be like, yo, who cares? You're gay. Big deal. Because it's not a big deal to me. That's what he's trying to do. And it didn't come across.
You're probably
like that.
Right. But guess what? I definitely didn't give a fuck. Yeah. I definitely didn't care. Like all the different conversations we could be having right now.
Yeah.
Why are we putting this young man on the spot?
Do you think you would have cared more if he was more thick?
If he was thick?
Yeah, like if he had that fucking hocks right there, dog.
His ham hocks.
I'm going to be honest with you. You know
Kaz the body. This makes Famu eat it. Kaz the body, Famu eat it.
Everybody knows.
Like a stallion, bro.
Everybody knows.
Kaz the stallion,
bro. You're a chariot. You're not even a stallion. You're the shit being dragged by the horse, bro. You're playing fucking games with these people out here.
And Charlamagne want to be your gladiator.
Everybody knows how I like my gay men.
Driving the boat.
I like them loud, okay? I like them loud and outrageous.
Flamboyant.
Not even flamboyant. Like, you can, I just like you to be loud. Like, I like the gay man that
like, you can see the gay from a mile away.
Yes, yeah. The guy that walks in the room and be like, ooh, look at you in those little gray short pants.
Right. I'm not gonna lie, I felt kind of turned on just now. I was like, I like that compliment.
Like
that
my homeboy
nice.
Terrence,
man. Terrence gay. Who cares?
Art clip.
Yeah. He said he was gay. Who cares?
Who cares?